What's going on, everyone? Welcome back to another video on my channel. And today we're going to be reacting to my 2019 AFL predictions for this season. Unfortunately, I don't think I did too well at all, and I've been reminded quite a few times about certain predictions that I had throughout the year, most notably the Melbourne prediction for the grand final and Port Adelaide's prediction as well. So I haven't had a great time spending trying to predict this season, but nonetheless, I'm going to go through the pain of watching the video again and seeing where I went wrong so I can improve for 2020. So let's get straight into it and see exactly what I predicted for 2019. 18th Gold Coast. Well, I got that right. Simple as that. That was probably the only thing I got right. They did improve in the first five games. There were three wins. There was a rest. 17th, here we go. Look. Yeah, not my greatest work, that one. Melbourne ended up finishing 17th, so yeah. Here we go, 16th. Carlton, they had a great second half of the year, won't lie. At the start of the year, I thought they were going to be wooden spooners, but they improved, so they did well. I'm going to give myself a tick for that one. I really feel like I got Carlton spot on there, so yeah. Oh, the Western Bulldogs made the 8. Oh, put them 15th. They were looking pretty poor at one stage, but they just stuck at it and they ended up pushing Port out the 8. Gosh. I am sorry, Geelong fans, I really am. You got 4 minutes into this video and you watched me say your team's going to finish 14th. Some freak on YouTube who thinks he's pretty good at predicting the season, and that's what I dish up. They ended up finishing top of the ladder, got knocked out in a prelim. Piss poor. Piss poor. Did I get that right? Fremantle, 13th. They did alright. You know, they were alright for the first half of the year. Looked like they were going to make the 8, and then they dropped off a bit. And so I think I'm around the mark with that one. 12th. They made a bloody grand final, mate. Mind you, they got smashed in it. That is a failure and a half, man. I've done that bad of a performance in 6 or 7 spots. And I'm already feeling like I need to switch this off. Brisbane! Another shit prediction. Mind you, how was I supposed to know they were going to finish second on the ladder? They did go out in straight sets, but watching them play football this year was some of the best football I've seen. In 2019, they were so exciting, and I said 11th. That surprised me. People might even make the 8. They did. They finished second. So 10th, Sydney. I predicted they wouldn't make the 8. They didn't make the 8. So there's a tick for myself. All right, 9th on the ladder. I got that right. I think I got that right. They didn't make the 8 on percentage, I think it was. Percentage or a game out. They finished 9th. That's a massive tick. I got one. 8th, here we are. Yeah, I didn't quite get that right. I thought they were gonna be around the mark. They played some good football towards the end of the year, did lose their coach, so I think it's a failed prediction in a sense because they didn't quite make the mark, but in saying that, they improved later on, got a new coach for next year, so yeah, not a great prediction again. 7th. Which we did, we dropped. I feel like now we're a little bit more unpredictable with We were unpredictable. It was so unpredictable. It was so inconsistent. It was actually... I've never been through so much emotions throughout a season watching my football team than I did watching Port Adelaide. I finished 10th. It was a safe option because I had no bloody idea. 6th, here we are. They finished 8th in the end. They were, again, a little bit off. And towards the end of the year, they were starting to fall off a bit. And then they obviously finished 8th just and went over to Perth and played West Coast, were okay in the final. But, you know what? Not a bad prediction. 5th. I predicted them to finish 5th after making no finals the year before, a grand final the year before that. I thought they'd bounce back. They didn't. They lost to Hawthorn in round 1. And they were just... they were poor. Now they've lost their coach. They've cleaned out everyone. They're not even going to have enough players to start next year. They weren't a good team to watch. Another wrong prediction. 4th is Collingwood. I thought they'd do the job. They did somewhat what I'd expected them to do. They made a prelim. I thought they'd bounce back and make a granny. They were okay in certain stages. They really built up. A lot of injuries hurt Collingwood. And it was probably, I think, where they finished in the end? They finished 3rd, was it? I think they played... I finished fourth because they played Geelong. Richmond, 3rd. I got that right. So I got the top, 2 of the top 4 right so far. Which was good because I predicted Richmond to finish 3rd. And they ended up winning the premiership. West Coast 2nd. Well, they finished 5th in the end. They failed towards the end of the year, lost to Hawthorn in the last round, and then obviously bet Essendon in Perth. Then went over and lost to Geelong at the G. So, yeah. I mean, they'll be around the mark next year again, obviously getting Tim Kelly and having a very strong midfield, so... Oh no, why? Why? They broke no hoodoo. They broke my spirit to predicting things. 1st, and they finished the other end of the ladder. I'm sorry, Melbourne fans, I'm sorry. I probably jinxed you. I didn't thoroughly enjoy them watching this year. There was never a stage where, even if you weren't a Melbourne fan, did Melbourne give you hope to predict or give them a chance. Every time you thought they'd have a chance, they never bounced back. That's an embarrassment. What a... oh, it's even worse. I did a Kane Corns, apparently. I got nowhere near a prelim, mate. Shut up. I don't want to hear it. So for the Brownlow and for the Coleman Medal, I just gave off some names that I think could potentially win. Didn't predict an exact winner. Probably playing it safe there, but we know that Nat Fyfe won, and we know that Jeremy Cameron won from GWS the Coleman Medal. So I think overall prediction wise, not my greatest. I won't lie. I think next year I'm gonna have to up my game. I did actually sit down and think about these predictions. I don't just rough them off on a piece of paper and think, well, first thought's the best thought. But in saying that, you could almost argue that my first thought is the worst thought, because that's just shite. Two or three predictions right. Obviously, you're not going to get all your predictions correct, but as someone as myself who prides themselves on watching a decent amount of football and, you know, think I know somewhat what's going to happen, it was just that type of year where you just couldn't predict anything. And my predictions showed that. And I'm just going to delete this video off my computer. It's not going to be anywhere near anything again. Because that was shit ass. Thank you very much for watching, though, everyone. Appreciate all the support. It's good to be back from a little bit of a holiday break. So continue the content right and through till Christmas now. And if you got any ideas, let me know in the comments below. And what you thought of the 2019 predictions from myself or yours as well. How'd you go? And let me know what you're thinking for next year, because it's going to be a new decade, 2020. So I'm very much looking forward to it. Make sure you subscribe to the channel if you're new for plenty more Port Adelaide and AFL content coming your way across the off-season. My name is Anthony, and as always, can't bear.